We're getting there.
Running into a couple problems here. I guess first and foremost, I pushed most of the dirt back there. I'll be able to level it off. I decided I'm going to level off that entire side of the yard. I've been wanting to do that anyways. If you can see, I don't even cut the grass way back there because it's just too dangerous. So I think I'm going to just level it and then rake it and seed it and I'll be fine. I did hit a drainage pipe, but not the type you'd think. It was for rain runoff. It starts here and then it goes to right there. And that's just a plastic pipe. Not even, it's like a flexible pipe. I knew it was here somewhere because it comes from over there and goes around. But anyways, back to work. I gotta get this done. Whew, so there we have it. It's the hardest work is out of the way. Well, it's not hard to drive this thing, but this gotta go back in a couple hours. It's only a rental. The majority is dug out. You can see that it's like a lot of soft soil in there. I'm going to be using that to pad the bottom. I still need to shape the sides with a proper spade shovel, or I'm sorry, a flat shovel. And I've dug it 5.5 feet deep to allow me to shave off the sides nice and smooth, and then smooth out the bottom, and then drop in some protective things, and then the liner, etc. But right now, I have got to fix my yard. You can see so many dips in my yard. I'm going to level out my whole yard. I don't care. I've got a couple hours. I figured I'll go level it out. I'm telling you right now, look at this. I'm constantly, literally replacing lawnmower blades. I think that's the third set this week. This season. So, it'll be nice to have a nice, smooth lawn so that lawnmower's not always getting ripped apart. Day two. Yeah, it's not gonna be a good day today. I gotta level out this whole yard. Luckily, I've got enough dirt to do it. You can't see it now, but like if we come back here and you'll see the reason why I wanted to do this in the first place with all this extra dirt from the pond. Like this is about two feet of dirt and it's still not level with the rest of the yard. Like I lost so much of my yard back here because it wasn't level. I'm gonna flatten this out, then flatten out the rest and get to work on the actual pond here. Whew, take a look at it now. Flattened out the bottom a little bit, raked it out. It is looking good, but I do have a plan for it. Let me show you. I went out and picked up a bunch of pressure treated lumber. I got some 2x4s because I'm going to frame up the walls, and some 3/8 pressure treated plywood. This stuff will be good for about 40 years. The plan here is to basically build walls on the inside so we have completely flat walls. This way I don't got to mess with the rocks or worry about anything or nothing like that. The bottom I'm going to soften out with probably sand and drop that liner in. But today I hope to get the whole yard leveled out. Tomorrow get this in and then backfill the walls. Well, I still have this little dingo thing, whatever they're, I don't know, a little mini bulldozer type thing. But that's where we're at now. The pond is sitting at 6 feet deep. It's gonna be a good one. I also want to tell you some other plans that I have. This deck I built, I'm going to build it out 4 feet wide until, I guess what I'm gonna start by doing is building a 4 foot wide deck all the way around it. Identical to this, and then I'm going to connect the two right here with like a 4 foot walkway. It'll be pretty cool. If I go 4 feet on each side though, it's going to be 18 feet wide total, and this deck is only 16, but should be okay. I got a lot of work to do, guys. Let's get started. Yeah, way more work than I thought it was going to be. If you ever want to dig a pond, have a plan for all this dirt. I leveled it out as much as I can for today. I gotta get running. It's my son's birthday and take him for dinner and stuff like that. But right under this little pile, there's a tree stump. I don't know if I'm gonna rip that tree stump out or not, or just level it out here. I know another big deck I'm gonna put over here. I'm gonna connect it to the pond. That's for another future thing. I hate this. It's an eyesore, but I need somewhere to put, you know, the toys and the yard work and stuff. Because I don't have a garage anymore, because I decided I wanted a gallery. So now I got tiny little sheds and stuff like that. But yeah, she's looking good back here. I don't know about this area back in that corner, if I'm going to keep it sloped or maybe I'll level it off, but I have a feeling that's way more dirt than what was in the pond. I don't know if you can even see it on the camera right now, but all right. A lot of raking to do to get all these big rocks out of here. I'm going to level it out more. I'll probably start that in the next day or so, but you guys are going to see all this done and the inside framed up, I think. I don't know. Give me time. I'm only one man doing it all. All right, so this is what I was thinking. Building an internal frame just so I have completely flat sides. This is essentially the rough draft, though. Lots more to do here. Shortly, of course, I've got to level out all the dirt in here, flatten it, put some underlay down. Anyways, as for the external structure, it's just exactly how you construct a wall in your house with studs 16 inches apart. The top is braced, and this is all pressure treated wood. It's good for about 30 years in the ground. It'll be fine. This is 2x6s on the top just to brace it. I've also, as you can see, raised it a foot out of the ground. This is so that when I build the deck around it, it's going to be level with the deck or, you know, right below it. But we still have 5 feet of depth into the pond, into the ground, and a foot above it. So it's 6 feet deep. So it did go a little bit bigger than initially I had planned. But I will have to backfill it a little bit, and that's why the plywood's on there. Completely flat sides. It's gonna turn out well. I just gotta keep getting more work done to it so you guys can understand it. We'll come back in a few seconds here. This is where we're at with it so far. It's been a lot of work, and I regret doing this by myself. It's been incredibly time-consuming. I'm used to building a tank in a day or a couple hours, and this is taking me... Well, we've also had a lot of rain, so that hasn't been the greatest. But I do have the pond liner here now. It weighs over 300 pounds, so that's going to be difficult to get in here, but I'm sure I'll figure it out. All right, went ahead and flattened her all out. It's not perfect, and it's still kind of wet. But like I said, when this hardens, it's going to be hard as a rock. It's very similar to, you know, cement once mud hardens. Anyways, once it does dry up a bit, I'm still sinking into it by a couple inches. I don't like it, so I'm going to let this dry out. Then I'll rake it, get any more rocks or anything else that I can find in it. And we're going to put the underlayment in. And then, of course, the liner itself, which is here and waiting. So that's it for now, guys. Hope you're enjoying this series so far. I wish I could get it all done in one video, of course. This is a pretty big job. The most gallons I've ever built. Probably not the most difficult or the complex. The 2000 was definitely that. But I also don't recommend doing this alone. I probably wouldn't recommend building it as I am. I don't see why you couldn't, but... I wanted something very specific, and that's what I'm doing. There's more than one way to do this, and keep that in mind when you're building yours, if you do want to build one. Anyways, if you guys want to see any more of this, you're not subscribed to my channel yet, make sure you do, or you're going to miss the videos.